me try this again. All right, that seems to be working. So I bet you thought I was done with that driven pulley with an 8-tooth keyed sprocket, but I'm not. Went to the hardware store. I got these at Harbor Freight. Got some of these copper washers. Got some of these. These are SAE O-rings. I also got a big assortment of these metric ones just in case. But I didn't need those metric ones because I used a 5/8. See how thin these are? Really nice and thin. Used one of those and these 5/8 inch spacers here. What do they call these? Copper washers. I'm using them as a spacer. And the reason why these are nice is because, let me zero this out. They're about 1.5 millimeters. These ones, these are, oh, I see, those are, oh, okay. This explains something. These are 18 gauge and these are 14 gauge. That's why, that was confusing me a little bit. All right. So that's 1.75. These are about 2 millimeters. But both of those are thicker than these, and you want these because both of those add up to 3. And that's about how much you want with that wide 8-tooth. For some reason, that thing's pretty wide. Oh, I also got this 5 millimeter key in the mail. Macca key, 5 by 5 millimeter square key. And it fits that perfect. It's really snug, just what you want. So here's this 5 millimeter key. And that's gonna fit real tight. It fits in there super tight. So that's what you want. And it also fits right in there. See, nice and snug. And I got a link, an affiliate link in the description. Everybody who's dealing with these things should have these. And I haven't cut one yet, but it's gonna be real easy to put that in a vise and cut it with a hacksaw or a sawzall. All right, so I'll probably take a picture of this if this doesn't come out on the GoPro, but I'll just show you what I got here. So I got the nut, 5/8 inch copper washer, pulley. That's the 3/16 key. Another copper. It's the 8-tooth sprocket with a key in it. And then I got one of these little 5/8 inch washers. And that's just taking up some slack. That's all that's doing. Everything's rotating the same. It's not gonna get wore out, or, you know, it's not gonna disintegrate in there because something's, you know, causing friction on it. It's just not gonna do that. If it does, just replace it, I guess. But see, the reason why this thing has play in it is because this thing goes back and forth, right? You're only tightening, when you tighten everything down, you're only tightening it to this lip here. So it's either going to be a washer or the edge of this, you know. And that's, I mean, without a key in there, see, when there's a key in there, I think it's a little bit different. You can torque everything down and the key might even press against the nut a little bit to get rid of some of that slack. I'm not sure how that works exactly, or how it's supposed to work, but when you're using a sprocket with a key in it, there's just all kinds of slack there no matter what you do. It's that much slack right there. Now what I was gonna do, and it would probably work too, to a point, I got a rat tail file and I started, you know, beveling the edge here. So that bevel would sit right against that shoulder. You can see it already, there's already a lot less. You could do that actually. There's already a lot less play there. But I decided to try this O-ring and it worked perfect, so that's what I'm gonna do. So you do the O-ring, and then you do the 8-tooth sprocket. And see that when you push on that, the O-ring kind of expands and it goes right up onto this lip, and it just creates a little, you know, it just puts a little bit of rubber in between the edge of this and that bearing race. And then you put another copper 1.5 millimeter. And this, I'm just using this just to demonstrate this. Put that on. Another copper washer. Nut. All right, and see, and that's a perfect amount of threads. And look, no drag. And I'm going back and forth like this. No play. No drag. No play. So that's the way it's going to be. And I think that would work for the 9-tooth. You might have to have different amounts of spacers or thicker ones. You know, you can choose either thinner or thicker ones. Double them up, whatever you got to do. But so the deal is now you got an extra 1.5 millimeters between the chain and the back of this pulley. But I think that extra 1.5 millimeters is going to do the trick. And then, you know, you can, everything moves a little bit. You can make it so this is more angled out a little bit instead of angling in a little bit. You know, put the whole engine out as far as you can. There's a little play in everything. So, and I'm going to do something similar over there. I got a different, on the CT200U, I got a different setup with a 9-tooth with a keyway. But I have the kind of the same issue going on there. And the chain's hitting and I have a washer on the inside and none on the outside. So I'm going to do something similar there. Maybe I'll make a video about that if I come to any conclusions. Oh, and I got this thing for like $28 on that website. I'll put a link to that website. It's on Amazon, but I went to the website directly. I think the shipping was cheaper or something. This drum was warped. Of course, this one might be too. I don't know. It looks good, but who knows? That one was warped, causing problems with the brakes. So I got this one in the mail, brand new for $28. Or was it 38? I can't remember. Whatever it is, I'll put a link and show what I paid for it and everything. I think it's called VMC. Chinese parts, VMC. They got a lot of like stock parts over there. Another thing I got there was this brake lever. That's a really good high quality one, just like that comes with the CT200Us, the Coleman mini bikes. That's actually, they say it's for the MB200 Trailmaster, but it was only $7. These ones were like $7 on eBay, but these are junk. Well, they're not junk. They're just made out of soft metal. And when you put them on, they stick out like about that far. So there's a huge pull on it and they stick way out. I guess there'd be some way to fix that. You could maybe put a stop right there so it didn't go all the way back in. And it has enough, you know, range, so it would work fine. But I just wanted to see if that would work, and it does. And they're cheap. And you know, ones on eBay and Amazon are like up to $25 for something like that. You know, sometimes it's 15 plus shipping. I don't know. These things are like disposable. I'm gonna pay as little as possible for this stuff. One good thing about these is there's such a huge pull on it and it sticks out so far. That's no good if your brake's working. But if your brake's not working good, I can see where that might come in handy, because you could you have a lot more pull on it. And if the brake drum's warped, you know, you can adjust it way out. Now, when you brake, it's going to be going like that, but at least it'll work. You wouldn't have to get a new wheel because you got so much more range here that you could, if you adjust it just right, you could have it so on the outside it's not hitting, but then, you know, on the high side of the brake, where it's hitting, it'll be like grabbing here, and on the low side, it'll be grabbing here. So it might be going like that, but at least it'll work. I don't know. That's the only thing I can think of good about these. Otherwise, they're just cheap. Maybe good for a spare. They're very lightweight. Put them in your backpack for a spare or something. I don't know. And I'm not sure if these even fit that perch. They probably do. That's something I'm going to have to check out. But anyway, so I got that there too. That was a good deal. And after I get all done with this, it won't take me long to put this together. It's, you know, put a chain on there, put the wheel on there. Actually, taking that tire off and putting it on that wheel might be a problem. I might take it over to Mavis. They put my Scorpion tires on those wheels for 10 bucks. I got some hand tools and I can probably do it, but for 10 bucks, yeah, just to save my back and knees, I might have them do it. Or maybe I'll buy some new tires. Yeah, maybe I'll just buy some new tires for this one. I want to get some 20 inch tires. These are 19 by 7 by 8. 7 is the width and 8 is the size of the rim around. So I might get 20 by 7 by 8, so they'll just be a little bit bigger around. Maybe I'll do that. Take this wheel over there, have them put that on there. Probably get some Kenda Scorpions. Maybe I'll try some different ones, but I like those tires. They're pretty good for what I ride. Not much pavement, mostly dirt and rocks and crap. So, all right. I don't know if I'll add this into another video or make it its own quick little video. But either way, I'll do an update once I get this thing running. All right, later.